If you want to get your physician engaged in something, you can go right at their core heart of what a physician is, and you say your patient needs your help. Any clinician, they really went into this to take care of their patients. And so when you tie quality to what's right for their patient, they bypass you and they move ahead of any initiative you have, and they bring that patient into the process before you can even identify how to do that.
Our patients, our families are too important for us to just give up on the processes and say, well, maybe not now, maybe later. We've got to continually find a way to make things run smoothly.
And it starts off by defining what quality is. I mean, that's not always been a major issue. You just kind of know it when you see it. In the past, well, now we have definitions of what quality is. So we have a definition. Once we define it, we work towards it.
In January, when we initially started and rolled this out, our total patient safety score for the month of January was 23, which meant we had 23 events, safety events in our hospital. And currently, here the month end of August, we've been able to narrow that down to 13 events. So we have not hit our target goal yet of zero, but we're on our way, and we're excited to see that significant improvement.
As a board, we've shown we're willing to change as change is necessary, willing to listen, willing to implement. Administration's willing to do the same thing, whether it be education, example, and sometimes probably loving pressure. We've seen a significant change in our culture.
We've infused the culture of safety in a lot of different ways. We've had different initiatives from back to board education all the way to frontline health and safety fairs. We do a morning huddle, and the focus is on safety, a culture of safety. And then we get into everything from our statistics to our patient safety, and then whatever's communicated in the huddle is sent out in an email to all staff.
We quickly realized that we needed to get more people involved in the design of the process. So it wasn't good enough for us to sit in our offices and try to create these changes and then go out and instruct staff on how to do these processes that we had designed. We wanted the overall improvement of the hospital to really should be integrated in all of the departments throughout the hospital. We're still rolling out phases of the quality revolution. It's never complete. The first phase had to do with that engagement, getting people engaged. The second phase of our quality revolution was to revolve around our value equation. So we taught staff, we taught our leadership team that every process that we do in this organization was going to encompass three methodologies. The lean, which is to eliminate waste in the organization. The Six Sigma, to decrease variance throughout the organization. And the third was the PDSA model, so that we could quickly implement things and test things and get those into play to speed up our improvement processes. Another motto that came from our Quality Revolution program was proceed until apprehended. So every employee was taught that utilizing the value equation, they really have the ability to go out and make change.
The doctors, having them champion it has been huge. Most of them have come on board and says, yeah, I get it. Let's have open discussion on what is best practice at this hospital. Let's all help us to be better.
We have engaged our patients and our family members at a few different levels in the organization in our quality efforts. And a couple of the ways is, one of them, we have a lot of volunteers. And so they'll come in on different boards and serve and give us advice. We have a formal committee that's called our Patient and Family Advisory Committee.
I don't have a patient's perspective. Doctors don't. Our CEO doesn't have a patient's perspective. Most of us don't have that perspective. We walk in the back door, not the front door, and so getting sometimes a patient's perspective through these panels, these groups where they sit down and tell us, you know, look, this and this and this are things going wrong and could be done better, that's helpful.
About half of our board time is spent on quality issues. We have another separate board meeting, which more and more doctors are choosing to be involved and come to our early morning board meeting. Quality meeting, as well as the directors of different departments coming and presenting to us what we've asked, and that is, what goals and thus metrics can you put in play into your department to help this organization with quality? Personal experiences carry more weight in a lot of ways than the data, but you've got to still know where you stand from a metrics standpoint. Both very, very powerful, and we're trying to implement both here at our facility.
I never envisioned when I started into quality improvement that we'd ever be able to get quality work outside of our department, the quality department. I never envisioned that we'd be able to get directors, managers saying, what can I do as a quality project? How can I make my patients' and families' experiences better? But to have a team that's willing to support one another, willing to give it a try, willing to think differently, is just the greatest success that I could have ever imagined.
I think the thing I'm most proud about with what we've accomplished at this hospital so far is that there is starting to be some real communication between administration and the people who are in charge of quality and the physicians. And again, it's changing practices, which are not necessarily bad, but they can always be improved upon.
I think the quality culture is sustainable when it becomes a part of your culture, and it isn't a mandate. If you've built it into your processes, the culture, the philosophy, and the community's expectations, that's pretty hard to change. It just becomes a part of the organization and the expectations rather than a policy that can be changed.